Good morning, students. How are you doing today? I hope you are fine and fantastic. I am a teacher of political science and my name is Jigyasu Punia. Okay, guys, so we are going to learn political science. Today's topic is very important and this is my second lecture. I formally welcome you on behalf of Tanaji's IAS Academy and here you can prepare with us till your selection. And we will be with you to guide you, to help you in any way you want from us. Okay, we are preparing for CSC 2021-22. Why Tanaji's Academy? What makes it so important? So here are few things which makes it important, guys. Okay, you see here the first point. First point talks about daily live classes. So daily live classes means you guys will get a way to interact with your faculty, your mentor. You can talk to us, you can engage in discussion, you can ask your doubts and you will be answered accordingly, guys. Okay, in second part you can see there is structured courses. Why these structured courses are required? You see, everyone is struggling what is the right material to read, from where to get that right material. All the things are available at this one platform, that is Tanaji's IAS Academy. So here you will get all kind of material that is required to have good preparation. Okay, coming to the third point, that is live test and quizzes. Look guys, we all are aware how it is important to have a test series and quiz that makes a class very meaningful. In my lectures, I'll make sure that you guys get all important quiz right after my lectures. Okay, I will include them in my curriculum. Okay, the last but not the least, fourth point, that is unlimited access. You will get an opportunity to get unlimited access to the archives of Tanaji's Academy. Here you will get pre-recorded videos. You can get to talk to the mentor, you can get all those things which are created only for you in order to make you guys capable enough to crack this examination. Okay, moving forward, that is me, your teacher, Jigyasu Punia. I have more than 5 years of teaching experience and I believe my teaching style is a little bit strategic, technical. You guys will enjoy it, definitely. I'll use a bit humor also, current affairs also, so you will enjoy it. Okay, let's go forward. Okay guys, let's come to the main point, that is subscription. As I told you, Tanaji's IAS Academy comes up with one great feature, that is plus subscription. Why this plus subscription? Because you will get certain things which you are not getting from any other coaching center. If you apply for 1 month, you will get to pay 7,000 per month. In the same way, the sequence reduces the amount of monthly installment. And here you can see it is available for 12 months, 24 months and 36 months. Okay, I would request you, if you are pursuing your graduation, so you must enroll yourself into 24 months and 36 months. It will be, you know, continuously enhancing your quality. And as far as 12 months is concerned, it is also a very good offer. You just get to pay only 3,000 for a month. Okay, so that is actually very good. Here at last you can see that free of cost you will get study material and that will be sent to your doorsteps by courier. Okay guys, so believe me, this is a good platform for your entire comprehensive study. Believe me and stay with us. Do take the subscription I mentioned you according to your relevance. Okay, finally, I believe you might have subscribed to this channel. Okay, if you haven't, do subscribe, like my videos and share my videos. And I will be available on this platform to make you guys aware about what is going on in political science or in Indian polity. You will get free YouTube classes and you will get to prepare for UPSC, MPPCS, UPPCS and BPSC. Okay guys, do like, share and subscribe. Moving forward, today's topic is very important and the name of today's topic is judicial activism. Judicial activism is very important. Without this, you can see many great things could not happen. So let's discuss this part. I hope You will enjoy it. But again, I would like to remind you, this is a demo purpose. I will not go into depth to make you understand. I will just give you an overview. Still, you are interested, you can enroll into the regular courses and you can join my classes and enjoy all the features that are required to crack this amazing exam of UPSC. Okay, here you can see judicial activism. So judicial activism, you will come to know what are the concepts, what is the meaning, the case studies and everything here. Okay, so why this judicial activism is important, from where this word has been originated, a very simple question that must come in your mind. So you guys are aware that Indian Constitution is such document that we have compiled so many things from great constitutions. So here this judicial activism is taken from American Constitution, okay, and it was there in 1947, but we actually took it during the time of emergency and after the emergency. Actually, this judicial activism play a very important role in order to empower judiciary and to play an important role on behalf of students, sorry, not students, like everyone, like every individual is a part of this nation. So they should know why judicial activism is important, what all things makes it so important, what are its pros and cons and everything. Moving forward, everybody, judicial activism, here is a bit definition about it. So let's discuss the definition, everyone. Okay, so judiciary plays an important role. You know, even today, if you are not satisfied with executive, if you are not satisfied with the parliament workings, the police is not helping you, still you have belief that judiciary will help you. Even a poor person who does not hold any kind of power, they do not feel afraid to say that I will sue you, I will see you in the court. That is what is all about judicial activism and the power of judiciary. You see, the judicial activism help in promoting the rights of citizen in a country. Okay, it have active role, like, you know, it upholds the values of fundamental rights, and these fundamental rights are very important. They should be preserved by the Constitution, and in order to preserve them, judicial activism helps in terms of legal system, to maintain legal system. And in the country, territory, executive, everything, like you can say, judicial activism is a key where judiciary crosses its body. That is called judicial overreach. It sounds like a negative word. Judicial overreach means judiciary crosses its body and takes the control of executive. They somehow interrupt them and make their own rules and empower them. So in that situation, we sometimes feel there is a contradiction between executive and judiciary. There is a contradiction between parliament and judiciary. So judicial activism is seen like a liberalizing access to justice. Like today, many people feel that they are not given justice. Okay, justice delayed is justice denied. So many important phrases are there. But to help those disadvantaged people, disadvantaged group, we need to have judicial activism. So in this term, we cannot forget two names, guys. Very, very important. It could come in your MCQ. So we are Krishna Iyer is related with judicial activism, and this PN Bhagwati is related with PIL. PIL is very important part, public interest litigation. Again, judiciary play very important role in terms to apply and enforce PIL. Okay, moving forward, everybody. There is a dictionary, we call it Black's Law Dictionary, that is from American, you can say Constitution, and the word has been taken from American Constitution, that makes it more important. So the word judicial activism has some meaning. The meaning is judicial philosophy which motivates judges to depart from the traditional precedents in favor of progressive and new social politics. The concept of PIL, you should know why PIL is required, why it is so important for us. So the concept is always talked of when judicial activism is discussed. Whenever we discuss judicial activism, we always talk about PIL. Very, very important. Alright guys, I told you already that we will go into depth, we will read so many case studies related to this topic, but still this is an overview, a demo purpose class. to enjoy this, you can stick with me. I will try to be my bilingual. I'll speak in Hindi also when you will be in my courses. Now it is required for me to, like, I need to speak this whole thing in English. So I'm doing so. Okay, guys. So moving forward, judicial activism method. Like, how judicial activism work. So in this sequence, I would like to mention few things. Like, first thing is what judicial review. How many of you can tell me that which article indirectly talks about judicial review? Yes, you're right. That is Article 13. Article 13 talks about judicial review. What is judicial review? Guys, judicial review do one thing. It actually, you know, interpret what is there in the Constitution. It reviews the laws in order to interpret them, in order to apply them to the Constitution. So judicial review is a very, very, very important aspect of our Constitution. You can see, without this part, we cannot have, there is a law which is good for people, whether it is void or not, whether it is null or not, we should know. And this thing all can be done by applying this judicial review part. Sometimes there is a conflict between legislature and executive. Again, judicial review is done for that. Coming to the next part, PIL. We know that public interest litigation. Here, person filing the petition must not have any personal interest in the litigation. We should know there should not be any personal grudges while you are applying for PIL. It should contain people into it. That is, it is called public interest litigation. Public is the word. Okay, not individual, it is public. Okay, guys. So here the court will accept your PIL, then they will apply it to, you know, for further considerations. Once it is accepted, you will be accepted and your point of view will be taken care in future. Okay, guys, moving to the third part, that is constitutional interpretation. As I told you, constitutional interpretation is very important, but that can only be done by judicial activism. Judicial activism helps in order to maintain a systematic balance between judiciary and the laws. And the fourth part is access to international statute for ensuring constitutional right. We all know that there are so many laws, even there is a International Court of Arbitration. Can you tell me where is ICJ is located? International Court of Justice or Arbitration is located? Please mention the comment section. Let's see how many of you are so smart that you know it. And one more thing, can you tell me who is the judge from India in International Court of Justice? Okay, do mention the comment section. I will definitely see the comments, and if you are right, I will going to be like your reply. Okay. Next part is supervisory power of the higher courts on the lower courts. So you see that sometimes higher courts also supervise lower courts in order to maintain the law and to maintain the system. Okay, what is the significance of having judicial activism? Very simple question. If we have something, then why do we have it? There should be some reason for that. So let's see what is the main reason. So it is effective tool. You know, it is very effective tool for upholding the rights of citizen and implementing constitutional principle when the executive and legislature fails to do so. As I told you, sometime executive does not perform their work, sometime legislature does not perform their work. In that situation, judicial activism plays an important role, and they talk about public interest. Citizens have the judiciary as a last hope. As I told you guys, aao bhai court mein dekh lenge aapko, theek hai na, aisa kai baar sunne ko milta hai na, right. That is what the power of common people. Never underestimate the power of aam aadmi. Okay guys, so here you can see, when all other doors are closed, everything is closed, all hopes are closed, the Indian judiciary has been considered as a guardian and protector of the constitutional right. So this is also important point. This could come in your MCQ or in prelims. Who is considered as guardian of constitution. This has come already in the exam, right guys? That is judiciary. Okay guys, moving forward, there are provisions in the article 30, you know, so few provisions which empower judicial activism. You should know those all provisions, guys. So let's talk about article 13. I have already mentioned you, this is judicial review. And article 32, constitutional remedies. We know these all remedies. There are five writs: habeas corpus, mandamus, quo warranto, prohibition, certiorari. Okay, and moving for the High Court. You know that writs can be implemented by either Supreme Court or High Court under these articles. If Supreme Court empowers writs under Article 32 and High Court under Article 226 and Article 13, I told you that is judicial review. Okay guys, so that empowers the judiciary to review or to declare executive or legislative or administrative null and void in terms of contravention with the Constitution. अगर कोई कॉन्ट्रावेंशन होती है तो इस टर्म में क्या होता है, दैट कैन बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज नल एंड वॉइड. ओके, मूविंग फॉरवर्ड गाइस, अकॉर्डिंग टू द एक्सपर्ट्स, द शिफ्ट फ्रॉम लोकस स्टैंड लाइक टू पब्लिक स्टैंड, देर शुड बी पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट. वी शुड नो दैट जुडिशियल प्रोसेस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, देर शुड बी मोर पार्टिसिपेटरी. आई जस्ट रिकॉल वन थिंग, रिसेंटली देर वॉज अ गैंग रेप एट हाथरस. So in that you might have seen that the family member of the victim, they are pleading to have a judicial inquiry under the observation of Supreme Court. Even though that government has forwarded their case to CBI, but they still wants it to, in the ambit of Supreme Court. That is what the power of judiciary, you know, people believe in judiciary. So judiciary should keep that belief, okay, alive. Judicial activism counters the opinion that the judiciary is mere spectator. ऐसा नहीं है, judiciary is not mere spectator. It takes big steps and these steps are very, very amazing. Okay guys, moving forward, judicial activism examples are required. So we do have few examples, okay? So let's talk about few examples. First is when Allahabad High Court rejected the candidature of Indira Gandhi in 1973. You might have seen there was some sort of, you know, rivalry. Indira Gandhi involved many government officers into the politics and into the proceedings of the politics. They used the resources of government in order to, you know, find Indira Gandhi culprit. Judiciary actually, you know, banned her. Judiciary actually punished her. So if we talk about 1979, the Supreme Court of India ruled that under trials in Bihar had already served time for more period than they would have had been convicted. So in that situation, the people who are under observation, under trials, you know, there were so many inhuman reasons, inhuman crimes during the emergency. So who can tell me when emergency was implemented? Okay, it is 1975. So emergency, which article talks about emergency? Article 352, Article 356, Article 360. So we'll talk about these also very soon, guys. Okay, so let's talk about the case study, that is Golaknath case. So guys, Golaknath case, again, it is very important. In detail, we'll take it when the time will come. There are so many case studies and they're very enjoyable. I'll make them in very simple language so that you can understand and enjoy the course. Okay, the question in this case, whether the amendment is a law, like the constitutional amendment is a law or not, whether the fundamental right can be amended or not. Yes, what is the answer of this question? Can fundamental right be amended? Yes, the answer is yes, fundamental rights can be amended, but there is a big but, that there should not be violation of basic structure. Very good, you guys are very smart, you know. So Supreme Court contended the fundamental rights are not amendable to the parliamentary restriction as stated in Article 13. So Under this verdict, it was denied by Supreme Court that fundamental rights cannot be amended. But in reality, they can be amended. So which was the verdict? And we will discuss that case study also. Also stated that Article 368, which talks about amendment, gives the procedure to amend the constitution but does not confer parliament power to amend constitution. Very good. Okay, everyone, let's go forward. Oh, here comes the amazing case study that we cannot forget, and this plays an important role in the history of judiciary. Okay, and that is what Keshavanand Bharati case. Okay. Well, guys, I will also talk about Keshavanand when the class will start. This judgment is important. You know, some people say if Keshavanand has not been there, so that means we would not have that all freedom that we enjoy today. So here is what was the verdict. The judgment defined the basic structure of the constitution, including fundamental rights, was beyond the ambit of parliament and that could not be amended. The basic structure of the constitution could not be abrogated even by the constitutional amendment. Okay, this is the basis in Indian law in which the judiciary can struck down any amendment passed by the parliament that is in conflict with the basic structure. Okay, so the basic structure is the concept that was given here, and you know what, the Supreme Court is very smart here. They haven't explained what is basic structure, and that is why they always, you know, wins the race. So here in 2G scam, Supreme Court cancelled 120 telecom license spectrum allocated to 8 telecom companies on the grounds that the process of allocation was flawed. So you see that the whole thing was amazing. You know, Keshavanand Bharati case talks about basic structure, and here we see the power of judicial activism. Well, guys, here a few more things are also given here. The Supreme Court rolled out a blanket ban on firecrackers in Delhi NCR area with certain exceptions. You see, there was so much of pollution, and to reduce the pollution, government has, you know, taken some great rules, but government should take, but Supreme Court enforced that thing. Oh, that is also called judicial activism. Supreme Court invoked terror laws against alleged money laundering Hassan Ali Khan. How can we forget this case, guys? So money laundering case was also a big part that was given verdict under judicial activism. So we will talk about Hassan Ali Khan case. Okay, aspirants should read about landmark cases related to the basic structure linked with the article. Okay, we know this thing. Moving forward, so what are the pros and cons of judicial activism? You know, everything cannot be always good. There should be some negative part also. So you should know what are good part, what are bad part of the judicial activism. So judicial activism in simple words means when judges interpret their own personal feeling into a conviction or sentence instead of upholding the existing laws. You know, sometimes when judiciary overreach the power and they get involved there by their personal conviction, and they give their personal belief to maintain the system in the society, what they believe on the basis of their knowledge. For some reason, every judicial case has a base of activism within it. Like every case is somehow judicial activism because it is depend on the intellectual level of the judge. So it is imperative to weigh the pros and cons to determine the epicness of the course of the action being carried out. So here you see, guys, sometimes we take it as a pros and cons also. Like judges sometimes get involved personally into the case studies and cases, and that sometimes leads to the different kind of verdict. Okay, guys, moving forward, pros associated with judicial activism we are talking about. So let's see what are the pros. So here we see judicial activism sets out a system of balance and controls to the other branches of government it accentuates required innovation by way of a solution. Now, sometimes, you know, judiciary do one thing, they control the other branch of government, that is executive, okay? In that situation, what happens? Judiciary is making their impact, like judiciary showing that how powerful it is. In case where the law fails to establish balance, sometimes the law is not appropriate, sometimes we believe that law is always on the paper, it is not in reality, you know, the balance is not there between, you know, judiciary, executive and legislature. In that situation, judicial activism is done, okay? It allows judges to get involved into the situation. It also places trust in judges, provide insight into issues. You know, judges can get involved into the cases and they give insights about the cases and they get the solution of the problem. So you see many examples are there which are actually discussed here. Okay, judicial activism helps the judiciary to keep a check on misuse of power. Also, the power should not be misused. You know, one case study I have read, there was a MLA or maybe some Vidhayak was there whose name was Raja. So he, you know, put some sort of banner just beginning of his village or a town that from this line the territory of Raja Bhaiya begins. You know, that is also a big problem, like we actually questioning the sovereignty of the country. So here judiciary take the control. In this issue of majority, it helps to address the problem hostility where the legislature gets stuck in taking decisions. So where legislature is not taking decision, being very lazy there, we can see that judicial activism plays an important role, guys. Moving forward, cons, what are the cons? So let's see what are the negative points for that. Let's see. Firstly, it surpasses the power to stop and misuse the or abuse the power of government. We know that it actually surpassed the government and sometimes judicial overreach, we call it. They can cross their limits, right? And they get involved into the functioning of the government. It clearly violates the limit of the power set to be exercised by the constitution. Like we know there is a separation of power. One should not get involved into others' power. It will, you know, somehow hamper the very system of the country. The judicial opinion of judges once taken in off for any other case becomes standard for ruling other cases. You know, sometimes judiciary involves in few things that they become a standard ruling for other cases. So judicial activism can harm public at large. It happens because it was not discussed among the ministers who are very well aware about the people they belong. So here comes the next part. Repeated intervention of court can diminish the faith of the people. Sometimes if government is again and again interrupted by judiciary, that means people will look up to judiciary but not up to government. So that is what misuse of power. Moving forward, everybody, judicial activism criticism. We actually have criticism for that also. So what is the criticism for judicial activism? Judicial activism has also faced criticism several times. In the name of judicial activism, judiciary often mixes personal bias. You know, sometimes judges give their personal opinion, not factual. Okay, and that is what where problem creates. Okay, let's talk about another criticism is the theory of separation of power between three arms. State goes for a toss. Like we know that there are three pillars, judiciary, executive and legislature. But when judiciary get involved in activism, that means the power of other sources has been taken away. And there is no fundamental right that any group involved in this context. Judicial restraint is talked about. So we talk about so many things. There are so many more points that we will discuss in coming time. Okay, let's talk about judicial activism versus judicial restraint. So what is judicial activism? We have already discussed. Let's see what is judicial restraint. As mentioned earlier, everyone, what is mentioned that judicial activism is the role played by the judiciary to uphold the legal and constitutional right of the citizen, that we know it upholds the value of the citizen. Okay, judiciary exercises its own power to implement or strike down the laws and rules that infringes the right of citizen, or it gives it for the good of the society, you know, it work for the good of the society. So that is what we talk about, judicial activism. Okay, while on the other hand, judicial restraint is a second phase of the coin. It is second phase, matlab dusra pehlu hai ye. It is polar opposite of activism, of the which puts obligation on it to follow constitutional laws while implementing its duties. It encourages the judiciary to respect the laws or rules set out in the constitution. So it encourages the judiciary, it helps the judiciary in order to respect the laws or rules set out in the constitution. Means judicial restraint stops the judiciary by crossing the limits of the judiciary. Okay, judiciary has gained power with judicial activism, as the judges can take up issue of suo motu, like they can take it on their own, whosoever thinks that their constitutional laws are being violated. So here so many laws are violated. Okay, the power is not ultimately given to the judiciary. Judiciary should talk about only the laws which are implemented into the constitution. Who is given the sole power of legislative power? Okay guys, so moving forward, executives have given the power. So executive should be responsible for actions, and that is why it is executive. Okay, so moving forward guys, way forward in judicial activism. What is the way forward? Let's talk about this one also. So judicial activism is a product fabricated solely by the judiciaries and not backed by the constitution. When judiciary surpass the line of power set for it in the name of judicial activism, it could be rightly said that judiciary then begins to invade the concept of separation of power. So we have already discussed this thing guys. Once judicial activism is done, it again and again involved into the those activities which are not pro-constitutional. It is against the separation of power, it hampers the quality and working of the executive and legislature. If I talk about judges can freely decide and make laws for their choices. So they get emotional and they make the laws. In it would not only go against principle of separation of power, it will also result in chaos and uncertainty in the laws. Judges will start writing his own laws according to their fad and quirks. That means they will think that they are the sole responsible for implementing the laws and making the laws. Whereas we have executive for implementing the laws and legislature for making the laws. So here, you know, somehow judicial activism get involved into the lawmaking body and law implementing body. Okay, judicial exercises has to be respected to maintain clear balance. They should maintain it. Making laws is the function and duties of legislators to fill the gap of the laws and to implement them in a proper manner. We should know that law should be implemented, and so that the only work remaining for judiciary is to interpretation. Judiciary should interpret, should not enforce. Only a fine equilibrium between these government body can sustain the constitutional values. Rightly said. Okay guys, so a few questions were also there related to judicial activism. What is the example? You know, that is why I'm telling you this part is very important in terms of your prelims, mains and interview also. So what is an example of judicial activism? An example of judicial activism for Keshwanand Bharati case. What is the difference between judicial activism and judicial restraint? Both are opposing concept. While judicial activism talks about courts taking proactive role and ensuring the protecting the citizens' right, where judicial restraint encourages judiciary to limit the exercise of their own power. So you can see one part is talks about crossing the boundary, one talks about not crossing the boundary. Okay, is judicial review good or judicial activism good? Yes, judicial activism can be good if the intention of the court is to protect and preserve the right of citizen and not merely criticize the government. Sometimes judiciary take it personal and they get involved into the fight with the executive to just lead up to their all personal agendas. That is wrong. So if it is done for the well-being of people, citizens, that is good. Okay guys, that is all for today's lecture. Okay, I finally talk about again Tanaji's Academy. I'm telling you this is very important. Our classes are starting very shortly. You can see that is 10th of October, will be live classes there. and you can register yourself. Believe me, everyone, you will get tirelessly effort done by us. We will make you feel that you are with the right teacher, not just you are paying your fees. Apart from it, you will have healthy relations with your teacher, okay? You will get live classes, face-to-face interaction, recorded lectures, study material, assignment, discussion class, test series and current affairs, everything at Tanaji's Academy at one platform. Okay guys, so you should know there is a scholarship test live, even today you can apply. Please go and apply for scholarship test. It is just $499. You just need to register it. You will get the result how good you have done for yourself. Okay, that these are the timings, 11 to 12, then 12 to 1, 4 to 5 and 5 to 6. Okay guys, so 5th to 9th of October, and after this we'll also take out 2 or 3 more scholarship tests for you all. Okay guys, so I hope you know it and I hope you like it. Okay, I will finally thank you on behalf of Tanaji's Academy. Thank you very much. Please prepare with us till your selection. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Enjoy yourself. Bye-bye. Shabakhair. Take care. Bye-bye, everybody. Okay, I end my session here.